new. Hey, that's brand new. See? I like it.
If you're not playing a sport, you have camp chip in the winter, all working together, and then finally gets in the season, and it's every single day you're working hard, practice, games, lifting, not much time off, and it's just intense. And it's just, Coach Howell's built this program to where we just have such high expectations for ourselves that we have to work hard.
Going into the season, I was confident with our team, but our first couple scrimmages, we hadn't really been playing well, and we had a lot of guys who were injured and were out. So, I was a little hesitant to see how we were going to do. I couldn't tell you that we were going to go to both IAC and state championships. I couldn't say that in the beginning of the season. But I felt that, we had a really good group of guys and a lot of talent. So, if we worked really hard, we would get there.
My memory is like the first day of senior year practice, like when we first got out there in February, and I'm just like, it's all hitting me like, wow, this is all our last years together. Like, this is going to be insane.
going into the season, I think all of our focus was just on that championship weekend for us, just being able to get that banner and bring it back to the school to kind of cement our legacy. You know, we've been putting in so much work in the off season and the winter, and we really kind of need some to validate that hard work that we've been putting in.
Bender, everything you've got.
Let's go.
Will Sterrett, come on. Go!
You know, last year we did really well in the regular season, but we just couldn't finish out.
Had great wins against Landon, Prep, and then I think at the end it wasn't what we wanted last year, which was an IC ship and a state ship. But I think this year, it gave us determination to win.
We knocked out second round of states, first round of ICs. We had a tremendous regular season. You know, we went like 10-0 or 11-0, and then we lost like one or two, and then we went on another long winning streak. We beat Landon in four overtimes. We finished as the second nationally ranked team in the US, and then we beat Prep, who was also a top 20 nationally ranked team. And I think pretty much what the problem ended up being was that we went through the entire regular, we put all of our chips in the regular season. You know, we never really like had a true like humbling experience where we were like, wow, like we aren't that good, we need to get back to work. I don't think we had the drive to make a championship run. I think we kind of thought that it would just be handed to us and we would just be able to waltz into the IC championship and into the state tournament. And the fact of the matter is that that's not how you win a championship. That's not what championship teams do. And so that was really tough on us. You know, I saw, had to look at seniors in the eyes and say, I'm sorry, like, we didn't do this for you. And that was really a hard thing to do.
I came into this program the year before they won the high seas and the state, and there'd just been a three-peat in the states my sophomore year. And so it was kind of like, states are a given.
The next day we played Prep in the semifinals at home and lost pretty badly there, so. Probably my worst lacrosse memory is that.
So that really, I think, helped motivate us in going into this season this year.
Dress, take care of yourself so that you can be here to help your team get better. Today was a good step. Let's keep it going in that direction.
Family on three. One, two, three.
Family.
Don't forget your gear.
The class of 2016 could be the most tight-knit group of guys I've ever seen. We've been playing forever. It feels like almost a decade. We've developed a real good chemistry with each other, and we know all of each other's tendencies and all that stuff on the field, so it makes it real easy to play with and a lot of fun as well.
We have 16 seniors this year, one of the biggest senior classes Coach Chapel's ever had.
I also heard that this was the year to do great things with the team. Like, this was the most talented team in a while.
I would say, you know, the team felt like a family my freshman and senior year.
There wasn't like this usual hierarchy with seniors, juniors, sophomores, freshmen as there used to be. It wasn't as ridiculous. Everyone was comfortable with each other.
It's fun, not that much hazing. Kind of had to take the cones and balls out for the games and everything, but it was easy. The seniors made it really easy, made us welcome, made us feel like a family.
We avoided a lot of infighting, basically. We had three great captains, Sam Dyson, Emmett Dunn, and Wade Shervin. And they definitely took charge a little bit, but they also let other seniors who had just as much experience express their opinion. And you definitely saw guys, if underclassmen messed up, you'd see seniors with their arms around them saying, like, you're going to do it again, you're going to be better this time. And I definitely feel it was more of a team, and everyone just cared about each other so much.
He was kind of messing with us last night on Snapchat. And he was like trying to motivate us with the Flickr page from 2013. And he was taking pictures of like them celebrating, and then he took pictures of us in the crowd as freshmen. And then it dawned on me and to my friends, like, wow, I never thought we'd be in this position, like that we're on the field playing for the championship that we were watching.
Watching them win it at Landon in the way they did, especially after how they got there, they beat Prep, they beat all those other guys. They just came together and they took care of business. Seeing that just made me want to win it that much more.
Field, everyone was supporting each other. One of the greatest things about this year was no one ever dug into each other after a goal was scored. We were all like, bring it in, let's fix the problem, and then we'll get it right the next time.
This is my last year at this school, and this is my last year playing lacrosse for this school. It's Tybalt's last year at this school as well, and that couldn't motivate me more to have him come out with something that he can bring back to St. Chris and show off there. And it's something that all of us and the seniors can brag about at college and stuff like that. But it's more for the school and the community and giving back after all these years of going here. And that's just all the motivation that I need.
Again, look, high tempo from the start, you got me? So create those opportunities through your effort. Play hard for one another. All right, we got one last run together, let's make it count, understood?
Sure.
Think about what we did here together on Sunday, right? We are blessed to have this opportunity, don't waste it. Have fun, okay, play for one another, but let's go take it to people the next couple days. Got me?
Yes, sir.
Have fun, work hard, play the game plan, let's go. Go. Family on three, one, two, three.
Family!
So the IAC stands for Interstate Athletic Conference. And there are two teams in Virginia, that's us and Episcopal. And you have one team in D.C., St. Albans. Then you have Bullis, Georgetown Prep, and Landon, all in Maryland.
Yeah, and it's one of the better conferences in the country for lacrosse. Mm-hmm. I'd say top five, really, because I haven't really heard of this stuff up north, but I'm sure they're really good. But it's a really competitive conference. Usually it's dominated by Landon and Prep, but as the years have gone by, us and Bullis have gotten up there to starting to dethrone them a little bit.
We don't have that many boys. I think we have like 200 something boys. And if you look at these other schools like Landon and Prep, you know, they have so many boys to choose from. So I think that is just a big underdog, makes us an underdog too. But also is that I think that, you know, Landon and Prep, and like Bullis, they have a really good reputation, and they have a solid, you know, national reputation as a program, and that's something that we don't really get credit for.
I think people do underestimate our team very much. We have just a couple D1 commits on our team and a bunch of D3 commits. And so when we play Landon or Prep or Bullis, they have huge numbers of D1 commits and players who are very highly recognized. And so people definitely do underestimate us. But what made us great is that we played as a team.
Last year we looked at lacrosse forms before our Georgetown Prep game when we won that game 8-6, I believe. And the lacrosse form said we were gonna lose like 14-6, like something ridiculous like that. And we just looked at it and like, have some faith. Definitely looked down upon us because just not as many championships. And I definitely think that drives a lot of kids because they want to be the best and they want to be known as the best, remembered as the best. Even if they're not going D1, like most of our team isn't, they still strive to be the best and that's all they want.
Yeah, if we get talked about, we get talked about. If not, we don't. And I just can't wait to play the guys that they talk about and then we beat them and see what they say.
We've always been the underdogs, and that's how we like it.
Green seagull turn a deeper blue.
I could not foresee this thing happening to you.
So have fun and go get it. Let's go, Agnes. Come on, boys, right from the start. You got 48 minutes. Enjoy every second of it. Family on three. One, two, three.
Family! You know, Coach Towle took over in 2006, 10 years ago from this year. And when he took over, St. Stephen's wasn't a very program that was on the map. It wasn't, didn't have much talent. Didn't have the kind of culture around that it does now. And so he really built that foundation for the program.
He was telling us yesterday after our win, we won 23-2 against Cape Henry. And in the huddle, we were all happy and jumping up and down like we just massacred the team. And the one thing that he said to us was that's how this program was when we started. And he used to say how when he took over the program, he used to get beat by teams by this much.
You know, he just always pushes you. And I think that the most important part about Tybalt is that he really tries to, you know, compare lacrosse with life.
One of the things Tybalt always says about lacrosse and this team is it's actually not about lacrosse, it's about becoming a better person, a better man. And so I think he really instills that idea onto us, and he says that if you become a better man, you will become a better lacrosse player because you'll become more accountable for your teammates, and you'll be able to push yourself harder.
This is my favorite time of year.
Yeah.
Okay. Because much like it's in life, in my opinion, everything that you get now, you have to earn. If you want to play tomorrow, you have to earn it today. All right. And anything good in life is worth fighting for. So if you care about this team, you do your job today, you earn it, so that we can keep playing tomorrow. Understood?
Yes, sir.
It brings a sense of hard work more than anything else, and a good character. He doesn't let you be a bad person. Like, kind of bottom line, if you try to fight him on that, like, he's not going to take it. He's not going to take you being a bully or arrogant or anything like that. He's not going to take you being lazy. And I respect him so much for that, because I'd been around coaches who just wanted to win, who just wanted to have fun, and didn't really care how you got there. If you just sat around all day, skipped practice, and then came and scored 5 goals, they're like, all right. But if you did that with Coach Tybel, you would not see the field for like 3-4 weeks.
He's definitely been one of the driving forces in how much I love playing, and I honestly can't thank him enough. You know, he's sculpted the player I am and the person who I am, and I've played with him for 8 years almost. And so having a coach in your life for that long is, it's impossible not to leave a lasting impact on you.
Look, I could not be more proud of the team that you've worked to become.
Attacker, right?
That's the hardest thing to do.
Defense, number 21,
Agnes. I used to get 35 guys for the beginning of the year. You've done that. And along the way, you've won 90% of your
game.
There's nothing you've really done wrong.
Just
go have fun. If you care about the guys around you, if you trust the guys around you, what the hell are you worried about? If you outwork them, you do your job, and you get it done. You got me?
Sure.
Let's go. Hands up.
Let's go.
Enjoy the ride, boys. Family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family.
First IC game, we're obviously really pumped to play them, but when we played them, you know, I just didn't feel that energy of like really wanting to just, I don't know, to beat them, I guess, you know, and shown in the game. I mean, we had a lot of turnovers, lost some face-offs, and couldn't clear the ball as well, and it just, yeah, it didn't really play out.
I guess we were a little nervous, you know, but yeah, I mean, like, we just didn't play very smart that game. I mean, I think it was obvious to the fans, you know, even to Landon, that we were the better team. We just didn't play smart. Yeah. It really hurt us.
Yeah. It was first IC game, so I guess we had a little nerves, but we were turning the ball over left and right.
15 times, 15 turnovers, something like that.
Just not shooting the ball well. Just defensive breakdowns that were just not, never really have. It was not a game we showed up for.
They just had a couple plays that didn't go our way and it went their way, and I think that's why they won 7-5.
We just made some mistakes that were, it wasn't necessarily talent-based, it wasn't necessarily effort-based. I think a lot of kids killed themselves that game, and I think one of the most reassuring things after that game was Coach Tybel said, I'm not mad about this game, we just need to focus more. And I think that game definitely helped us a lot. Like, it just turned a switch for us. That's like, this is real. Like, we have to fight for this. Like, the IC isn't going to be given to us. Nothing's going to be given to us anymore. We just got to go. And then I think the semifinals against Landon, we were going to win that game. We were on the bus, and I remember everyone kind of sits in their same spots on the bus. And I remember just sitting there and just thinking, like, there's like no way we lose this game. And it wasn't necessarily being cocky, it wasn't necessarily being arrogant, it was just, I knew this team, and there was just like this vibe about us. We just played Cape Henry, we beat them like 23-2, and it was just like, we aren't going to lose. We're going to put like everything we have in this game, we're gonna do whatever it takes, we're gonna kill ourselves if we have to win this game.
And hit records on my demo. Did y'all boys not get the memo? I do not stay at the Intercontinental. And anything I got is not a rental. I own that mom. Figure it out, this shit is simple. My stock been going up like a crescendo. A bunch of handshakes from the fakes. But I do not wanna be friends though. I tell y'all mom, man, this shit is not a love song. This a stripper on a mink rug song. This a f***ing boys forever hold a grudge song. Pop some champagne in a tub song. Just because song.
Dang. What's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. And they don't have no award for that. Trophies. Trophies. and they don't have no award for that. Don't come with trophies, ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm supposed to.
I go to dreams with a suitcase. I got my whole country on a new way. She like, I heard all your stay where you stay. House so big, I haven't seen them boys in 2 days. I use a walkie-talkie just to get a beverage. I saw my parents split up right after the wedding. That told my ass to stay committed, f***ing credit. Check the numbers, I'm the one who really get it. I told y'all motherf***ers, man, this shit not a love song. This a doing me and only God can judge song. I do not know what the f*** you thought it was song. Pop some f***ing champagne in a tub song. Just because song.
What's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. And they don't have no award for that.
And I think leaving that game, we knew that we could do amazing things.
Prepare for him like we prepared for most really good face-off guys, but I think we'll change that and it'll work in my favor on Sunday.
Sunday now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're playing three straight games now because both seniors are taking a senior trip.
Yeah, so we got a semifinal game against Norfolk today. If we win that, we advance to the state championship tomorrow. And then, yeah, regardless, we play Sunday at Bullison, 6:30 at night.
At least they think they're giving us a little rest with flexing it to the
moon. Yeah.
I mean, it'll be fun. I think it's definitely a challenge because going from a championship game to a championship game, because the guys in the state on that other side of the bracket aren't really, like, you can't really go in there and walk your way through a win. Like, they're going to be tough, so we got to put forth max energy.
They're going down state for states. I mean, I was very, very confident. I knew that we were that no one was gonna stop us. You know, we had all the state teams we played, we won every single state game in the regular season. So there should be no reason why we should lose in, you know, the playoffs for states. So going down, like, I knew I was gonna take home that state championship.
Last year, I think it was, Matthew Fisher said something after we lost to Stab a couple weeks later in the playoffs. And he said, if we got to Richmond, we weren't gonna lose for states, and they knew that. Like, every team in the state knew that. And back then I was just kind of like, that doesn't make sense. But when we got there, I kind of realized, like, this team wasn't gonna lose to a state team. We were gonna win.
Score, Saints 11, Bulldogs 4. St. Stephen's St. Agnes advances to the finals of the state tournament.
Congratulations, Mr. McCarty. Looking at the stats real quick, we had 27 minutes of possession to their 21. You guys, in the second half, doubled them up in ground balls. Right, we won the face-off battle. You guys see what happens, correct? Okay, first half, we won goal game, second half, and that's got to be our focus. All right, be humble enough and willing enough to work to make the game play how we want to play. Okay? You got 2 more days to do it, and you have one of the greatest opportunities that I promise you in your young life. Yeah. Okay. There'll be more important things like family and all that stuff. But you have an opportunity to play for 2 championships. And you've done that because of the team that you've become collectively. All right, so let's make sure we're focused on that together. Got it? And enjoy it. Enjoy it.
we don't like Stab. I think any St. Stephen's, St. Anne's Belfield game you go to, there's going to be a little animosity. There might be a little trash talking. There might be a couple late hits. And it's just the two programs that don't like each other. If you look at it, Coach Tybel told us before the game that in the last 9 state playoff or championships, it was either St. Stephen's or Stab who had won the last 8. And I mean, that's just ridiculous.
Coach Tybel, there's one team he hates the most, and like any team, and it's Stab. He hates Stab. So because he hates Stab, we hate Stab too.
In Sands Belfield, they had like 6 Division I commits on offense. You know, they had just like, it's a pretty big program in the state, one of our big rivals.
They wouldn't even share film with us, because we didn't have a cameraman for our game when we played Stab in the regular season, and like they wouldn't even share film with us. And I think that there's just been history, there's been beef. In the previous years when we go down there to play them, like, there's just been a ton of issues on the field, and a ton of trash talking.
Oh, my freshman year, we actually played Stab in the semifinals with PVI, and can't say that I like Stab at all. At the end of our game in the playoffs, last game of the season, with under a minute left, we got in a bench clearing brawl, which is all you need to know about Stab. And then this year, they aren't really the cleanest team, and beating them feels really good.
Philly is look at these rappers, they silly as I don't know why they be guessing these suckers, but cause I am not feeling they different between me and most of these rappers. I'm talking about work that I really put in, talking about pistols I put on my hip, and I'm talking about foreigns I really could whip that I really didn't drove. Really was frozen my hood, and these bitches I really did hit. Really was shows, came up from nothing, and now they like I ain't made millions so quick. I'm in the back and they feel like a sofa. I done seen bitches a fucking on no.
Final score, St. Stephen's, St. Agnes 12, Stab 7. The trophy presentation will begin momentarily.
I want you to celebrate now, but by the time we get off the bus tonight, then we refocus, all right? But for the next couple hours, enjoy it. Enjoy it because you've earned it, all right? And I'm extremely proud of the way in which you competed, all right, and what you've accomplished, all right? So enjoy that right now. We'll go back to work in a little while. Got it?
Sir.
Please be respectful in line, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Great job.
Great job, Mike. Great job.
That's the block! Yeah!
Hey, careful, guys. Don't get hurt.
I think I'll
didn't necessarily feel like a championship. It felt like a semifinal game to me personally. I felt like, cool, we did what we should have done. Now we got to go do something that no one believes we can do. And I think that I kind of feel bad for the underclassmen a little bit, because I remember 2 years ago we lost in the ICs, and the celebration was so much different. It was just more like, we did it, and this is amazing, and this is surreal. And I remember my brother coming up to me and he was crying because he never won a championship before, and it was his senior year. And he was just so happy, and everyone was just so happy, like taking pictures after the game.
Right after the championship ended, as we were walking off the field, our captain Sam Dyson actually just yells, "I'm over it," like as we're walking off right in front of staff. And I think that kind of made everyone realize, we have business to do, can't linger on this win too long.
It was, we won, great, now we gotta go home and play tomorrow.
And this is how we'll do it, all right? All the seniors are gonna go as captain, all right? And when we do that, listen to me, when we do that, the entire rest of the team, coaches included, we will stand at the top of the box and watch them during their captaincy, all right? Because they have put together the greatest team in school history. The greatest team in school history, that's what you are, all right? So my only question is, why set up for one banner when you can fucking go number two?
Huh? Yeah, we're in!
Have fun. Play together. When I tell you to go after them, I mean it. Play with character and integrity. You got me? Go get it. Go get it. Family on three. One, two, three.
Family! Let's go!
Their attack ended up scoring every single goal for the team, which was killer. I mean, we had no way to stop them.
You know, you work this hard, have all the success, and you come up a little bit short. And especially we wanted to send Coach Tabel off with an IC championship too, as last year. But you know, I think we just didn't get the job done.
Thank you. I'll never forget any of you. I know I said it earlier, I've been pretty fortunate to be around a lot of good teams and have some success and players, but nothing like this. Alright, coming from where we've kind of felt like we were in the fall and all the work that it would take on your guys' end to really come together and be the kind of team that we needed to be successful, and to watch you guys go through that this spring and get yourselves to where you are, it's just, honestly, it was a privilege to be around, all right? And I respect the hell out of you guys for it. And I hope that if there's anything that you take from this, you guys, look, I mean, you're obviously, you had a boatload of success, okay? But what I want you to take from this is an understanding of when you really commit yourself to something that you care about and really, truly do it, you guys are going to be successful men. All right, you're going to be good at whatever you choose to do. You're going to be successful while you're still getting your education. You're going to be great fathers. You're going to be great husbands. All right, if you care as much about that stuff and make the sacrifices and commitments that you made to this team, to those aspects of your life, you're going to be just fine. All right, and that to me is the most important thing. Because there are a lot of people who choose not to do it. Because either they don't want to get hurt, or they don't, you know, it's too much work, or it's too much sacrifice by them, and they're too consumed with themselves. Those are the people that, they never, well, granted, yeah, maybe they never hurt like this, but it's because they don't care about anything. And at the end of the day, that's not living. All right? So I could not be more proud of you. And it's been an honor, obviously, for the time I've been here, but this year in particular, I wouldn't ask for anything else. All right? And again, I think tonight for me just, you know, it is what it is. But I don't for one second regret anything. And I don't want you to either. Okay? And I think, you know, again, for your, this senior class, for what you've done for this school and this program, you know, we can't thank you enough. And I think, you know, you guys deserve to be the most successful team we've ever had here. Because you guys worked your ass off. And you brought a team together, and you carried them the right direction. And so for you younger guys, okay, there's no excuse to not know a good blueprint to make a successful team. All right? You had 16 guys show you the way. All right? And you also have 16 guys who I know will make sure you're continuing to do the job so that they have games like this to come back and watch. All right? And that's your job. Okay? Because while a lot of great, great young men walk out of this room, there's a boatload still sitting in it. And it's your time and your responsibility to take that over for them. All right? But I will say, make sure you younger guys take an opportunity to thank them personally. Whether it's now, whether it's when they come back from senior projects. All right? But each one of them deserves that. All right? They're good guys. And they took good care of us. All right? And, you know, along the way, they also made themselves the best team we've ever had. Okay, so that's it. Look, I know you guys are cold and wet, and I don't want to ramble on, so I'll get you out of here. But I do want to say thank you, too. All right, some of you guys have been coaching for a long time, but even the ones who only had one season, 1 year to coach, this has been, other than, you know, becoming a husband and a father, having this as a part of my life has been the greatest thing on the planet to me. All right. It far surpassed ever playing and the teams I was on or anything. There's nothing else that I've been more proud to be attached to in my life than this. Okay? So I appreciate it because I know I pushed you hard and I know the sacrifice and all the hard work that you made and gave to get it here. And I can never repay you for that. All right? I can just say thanks. And that's it. That's all I got.
I mean, after that IC game, championship game, the first thought that comes to your mind is failure. Obviously, you set out to win both championships as we do every year, and we didn't. And I think at first, I definitely thought it was a failure. And that hurt, but the more it sunk in, and I think I'm still kind of realizing it, we had an amazing season. we went undefeated in the state, which is insanely hard to do. We won a state championship. We beat teams that were ranked far above us in any national poll. We became, I think, the most winning team in St. Stephen's history for lacrosse. And that's hard to do because there's been some fantastic teams that come through this school.
Every single thing I did in school was because of this program and striving to have that one common goal. And it's there's been moments that it's really challenged me, but there's also been moments where I've looked back and said, that's the byproduct of those challenges. That's why I went through those challenges. That's why I did all that crazy stuff in the snowy weather and the crappy rainy weather that made me want to cry and push those 45-pound plates on the field. And ultimately, I think when you invest so much time and effort into a certain thing, whether it be work, whether it be a sport, whether it be art, whether it be anything, you're going to experience some heartache. And I think we experienced that this year in the ISU Championship, but it's not because our team wasn't a good team or was a failure of a team. I think it's just because we invested so much, and I think that's living in the end, where we're putting that much time and effort into something, and at the end, it hurts.
I think that everyone on the team, from the moment we started at the end of the season to the end, we each got individually better. And, you know, we each built a bond with one another that I'll always remember for the rest of my life. And, you know, I think that just because we didn't win one IC championship, I don't think it's a failure at all.
Ultimately, we would have wanted that one more, that IC championship. But I think looking back on it, besides that one game, our team probably doesn't have many regrets. You know, we can look back in 20 years and say we had great times together. It was really fun. It was just a great group of guys to be around. You know, and I think all the seniors can agree it's going to be a couple months that I'm going to cherish for the rest of my life.
So, a really hard feeling to know that next year none of us are going to be together. None of us are going to be playing together anymore. But it was one hell of a ride.